Well done. Very solid result. You're looking good for the race.
Ever since the Sauber of Felipe Massa passed Jenson Button into Turn 1 at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004, Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012. We're here in the Yangtze River Delta today, home of the 16 corners that make up the Shanghai International Circuit. 54% of this 3.3-mile lap is taken at full throttle, and we'll be getting up to speeds of around 200 miles an hour with DRS assisting the cars down the back straight before they brake into the sharp hairpin at turn 14. Also here, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Now, I want to ask you about Sergei Sirotkin. As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed they'll be starting out of position today due to a power unit component change. So it's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. It's McLaren in pole position then. And starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Verstappen, Kevin Magnussen, and Grosjean, Hülkenberg, Sainz, Alonso, and Charles Leclerc, Ricciardo, Raikkonen, Sergio Perez, and Ocon, Hamilton, Hartley, Pierre Gasly, and Marcus Ericsson. Stroll and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. Okay, that's a good start. Keep it up. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Got that confirmed? Engine is looking a little worn. Power output will be less than optimal. We want to pit this lap, so push now. The gap between you and the car behind is increasing by a significant amount each lap. Good job. Pit now, pit now. Exit, exit now. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the ICE. Be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Fernando is in the pits. Nice work, that brings you up a place. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, the gap behind is 18.9 seconds. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, some information on Bottas. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Caution. Caution. Okay, clear. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Superb driving. That's the race win.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was, and an excellent win for McLaren. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
And now it's time to wind down and celebrate after that fantastic Grand Prix. Here they come, your top three, out onto the podium.